In the by the turn of the millennium, Harvey and Roma both began to fall into ill health, and they got to the point where they simply couldn't take care of themselves any longer, and they needed full-time care. So their granddaughter, Renee Carasosa, who lives in Tucson, invited them to come stay with her and her family in Tucson, and that's what they did. And they lived for, I believe, a little over a year with Renee. And the thing about their relationship was, like Tom said, the canyon was a divide between them. For decades, Harvey had devoted much of his free time to going out and covering routes, climbing buttes, and leaving Roma at home to do as she wished. And this had caused a lot of strife in their marriage. But by the time that they were together in Tucson in the year 2000, an interesting thing took place. And the to go back in time just a little bit, in 1959, Roma was involved in a car accident near Winslow. It was snowing, and her car spun out of control. She was thrown from the car, and it landed on top of her and crushed her pelvis. After that, she required a special bed in order to sleep, and so her and Harvey didn't sleep together after that because he had his own bed and she had her bed. And at that same time, Harvey was also stepping up his efforts in Grand Canyon, and so the divide between them grew wider and wider as the years went on. When they got to Tucson with the granddaughter, they had to stay in the same bed, and it was after that happened that they began to rekindle the feelings of love that had originally been there, and some of the old wounds were healed. And according to the family, by the end, they were very, very, drawing a blank here.
Close.
Close. Intimate. Intimate. Thank you, Tom. And they spent a very, very happy last few months together. They were in love again. They were cuddling like teenagers. They were giggling. They loved to watch movies together. They played Scrabble like mad, and she always beat the pants off them. And they just had a great time. Harvey outlasted Roma. She was the first to go. She died of a stroke on April 3rd, 2002. Harvey was holding her hand in the hospital when she went. The next day would have been the 74th anniversary of their engagement. Harvey was so distraught that he told his granddaughter he would give her 2 more months and then he would go. And 2 months later to the day, Harvey died, May 29, 2002. The coroner's report, or the doctor's report, medical report, said death due to heart and respiratory failure. But to ask his family, he simply missed Roma too much to be without her. In 2003, there was a ceremony to honor both Harvey and Roma and the recently fallen George and Helen Steck, another pair of big Grand Canyon hikers. And this is Harvey's granddaughter, or excuse me, daughter, Anna Dariaga, and her husband, Sam, placing Roma and Harvey's ashes into the canyon at Shoshone Point. And Harvey's gear was donated to the South River Museum. It's the gear that you see here on the stage. We'd like to invite you to come up after we're done here and take a look. Notice the hole in the bottom of the boots. Gear seen some miles. We'll have a couple minutes for question and answers. We just want to run this photo montage here.
With each passing day, and love is either
treasure on earth to be young at heart. For as rich as you are, it's much better by far to be young at heart. And if you should survive to 105, look at all you'll derive out of being alive. And here is the best part, you have a head start if you are among the very young.
I see a lot of familiar faces in here. I just want to especially thank the people who helped out with the research on this book. There's a great community of canyon enthusiasts here in Flagstaff, and all of them participated willingly in the work that Tom and I have done. And so, thank you. You know who you are. And also, thanks to everybody else who supported us throughout this.